Hi, I'm Izzy Dixon and I'm a productivity coach. I help people get their evenings and weekends back so that they realize that there's more to life than just work and they can actually enjoy the fruits of their labor. As part of that, I would like to answer a question today, which is how can I make myself more productive? Well, the good news is that you are the only person who can make yourself more productive. Nobody can make you do that. But that's also the bad news because yes, you have to do all the work yourself. Nobody can do it for you. People can help you and support you, which is what I do, but you have to do the actual doing of it. So first of all, you have to figure out how to do it. So here is where I can help. Let me start by saying that if you want to be more productive, you are already halfway there because it's a question of creating habits, and the basis of any successful habit is wanting to do it. So you're already on a good track if you want to get more productive. To be more productive, you need to put the right habits in place. So, and I'm going to suggest the four most important ones, and I'm gonna help you create those with some questions. So question number one is, what time do you actually start work? Do you force yourself to start work at 7 a.m. because you feel that's when you need to start, but you find that you're exhausted by 2 o'clock in the afternoon? Not everybody is a morning person, and no matter how hard they try. I'm not. And I have absolutely given up trying to change my basic wiring because it's impossible, to be really honest. If it's possible in your job, start at a time that suits you best, your internal wiring. That might mean that you have to work a little bit longer in the afternoon, especially if you get paid by the hour, but you will get a lot more done in the same number of hours. If you work for yourself, you'll find that you'll need to work fewer hours because the hours that you do work during the day will be more productive because they are during your natural productive time. So that's the good news. Number two, do you know the most important tasks for your day? So do you work from an endless to-do list, one that contains everything you will ever need to do until the day you retire? And maybe you're even adding to it every day because there's more and more stuff to do. So no wonder you're not getting anything done. You're basically working with overwhelm every single day and you probably don't even know where to start. Instead, create a list of items that you need to do that day and work from that list. Or tomorrow, if you prefer planning, in the evening. This list should be no longer than 3 to 5 items and contain the one thing that you need to get done that day to move you towards your goals. Also, make sure that the tasks that you have chosen are actually achievable that day, because you have to take into consideration the meetings that are already in your diaries and the appointments and everything else. So what's already in your diary? What else have you got time for? Those few things go on your to-do list. Because at the end of the day, you want the satisfaction to cross or tick them off. And again, that will help you become more productive because you'll actually get the things done. Question number three is, how do you react to distractions? Distractions are one of the main productivity killers. We can all understand that. It very much depends on how you deal with them though. Do you give in to them? Do you immediately jump on any notifications that pop up on your phone or immediately pop into your email inbox to see what's just pinged in? Maybe not, but maybe you are spending valuable time grumbling and being angry and being annoyed at the distractions. You're not getting anything done that way, but what can you do instead? So first of all, be aware that distractions are normal. They happen. We can minimize them, but we can't completely eliminate them. But it's how you deal with them that determines the impact that they actually have on your work. So First tip is minimize the distractions as much as possible. With the top tip is turn off all notifications, and I mean all of them, all the social media ones, all the email ones, turn them off. You don't need them. When you're done with your concentration work, you can then go back and check what has happened in your absence, and that's fine. So the remaining distractions, recognize that you're being distracted and then get back to work. Don't worry about it. If it's stray thoughts that may interrupt your workflow, write down what it is that you're thinking about, write down something that you might need to remember, and then move on. If it's people that are distracting you, tell them that you'll get back to them once you're finished with the thing that you need to get done, and make sure that you do that reliably. That way you'll set a precedent that yes, they will get back to me. It's a bad time now to distract them, and that's fine. Everybody will understand that you need to concentrate on something. Okay, that was number three. Number four, what do you do when you actually don't feel like working on your tasks? Procrastination, that's in, you don't want to do it, you can't be bothered, you really don't feel like it, what do you do? Well, we don't always feel like doing the work we need to do. That's human, that's human nature, we are humans. It's fine, it's okay. This is the time though when you need to trick yourself in some shape or form. For some of us this is easy. You simply say, well, tough, I just need to get on with it, and they do. For others, and to be honest, I include myself in that, we need to come up with some incentives. You could spend a couple of minutes visualizing your goal, the goal you're working on, and what will it be like when you achieve that? Picture it in the most vivid colors, the most wonderful pictures. What is it going to be like when you achieve your goals? If this is simply, I'll keep my job, then think of what you'll do with your next paycheck. Awesome, good stuff. What are you going to do? Are you going to maybe treat yourself to something? I don't know, it's up to you. Another option, especially that will work sort of for more regular use, is think of a little reward, something that you'll do immediately after the task that you're currently not getting to, that you're procrastinating on. This could be you listen to your favorite song, you will have a little treat. Personally, chocolate works for me, but yeah, that's just me. Probably not just me. Spend a certain time on a game you enjoy. Give yourself 5 minutes once you finish that task. Or maybe you have 5 things to do after everything you finish. You give yourself 10 minutes for the evening. So in the evening, if you finished all 5 things, you get 50 minutes on your game. How cool is that? So you can sort of clock up your time that you get to do something really fun in the evening, and make sure that if you don't do the thing, you don't get the time. That's how rewards work. We only get them if we do what the reward was for. But maybe you are differently wired and you work better with threats than with rewards. So what can you do then? If you don't do the task, you have to do something that you really don't enjoy. It might still be useful, but you really don't enjoy it. So that could be, if I don't finish this task, I've got to at a certain time, I've got to do 20 push-ups. That would definitely motivate me. Or you have to clean the toilet. That would also motivate me. Because yeah, we'll have to probably do those things eventually, but have to do it there and then. Might work for you. So what do you have to do if you don't do the thing that you're setting yourself to do? If you can get somebody to help you with that, an accountability buddy, who will hold you accountable so that you complete the task and also make sure that you do the punishment if you don't. So there's another idea. So how can I help? As a productivity coach, I can teach you all the tools and hacks that will make you more productive. And in a very personalized way. So I always work with my clients together on that. So I don't just say do ABC, because that might not work for them. We'll figure it out together. I also hold you accountable. And I want you to stay on track, especially while you're learning all those skills and while you're building the new habits. And that's really important. This ensures that these tools are not just something you know, but that you actually use. And that is the most important thing. Otherwise, it's just something we know. Doesn't help. We need to be doing it. And you need to be doing it on a daily basis, regularly. That will then help you be productive in the long term. If you're interested in this kind of support, I provide 3 months coaching. Simply get in touch. You can email me at izzy, that's I-S-I, at wellorganized.org. I'll put the link in the description of this video. Or you can pop over to my website, which is www.izzydixon.com, and you can check me out there. And there's loads of blog posts, and there is lots of tips and advice on the website as well as all the other ways you can work with me. So yeah, that's it. Please subscribe to the channel if you're new, and until next time, take care now. Bye.